I didn't really like mathematics, but I was really keen on physics. So everything that touch experience, try to understand why temperature changes, why things changes. I was always wondering, and I wanted to see and understand what was going on. And I was on this boat on the very first expedition, and I arrived and I barely knew nothing about subduction zone. I mean, I knew the name, but I knew nothing about it. And I was sitting next to somebody, quite experienced researcher, and I told him, yeah, sorry, but I know nothing about subduction zone. Can you just tell me what to read or something like that? And we had a lot of time in front of us. He was like, well, sure, so you should read this and this. And this is when I realized that I was reading a book about like one of the Bible of the subduction zone that was actually written by Casey Moore, the guy that I was talking to. And so this is how I started. Like, I was like, wow, that's super cool. They said, whoa, it works. Okay, right. And then I get into it and I never went away from this.
Okie dokie, we
know where
this spot.
So I was with colleagues that I knew, I've been knowing for a long time, and I was like, two of them were the co-chief, and I was like, I'm going to be a co-chief. I'm so scared. And they were like, you're going to be great. Don't worry, go for it. And I was looking at them every day, you know, trying to be stressed by the operation and, you know, trying to get everybody work together. And I was like, oh, that's going to be me.
Because here, all of that, this is the...
As a co-chief, but also as a scientist, I always encourage people to communicate. And that's, you know, something which is probably much easier on the boat, because you're not just, you know, PhD student in front of a big professor. You're basically living in the same space 24/7. The magic operates most of the time, where the PhD students, the frontier that you have between PhD students and professor, for instance, start to disappear.